We are going to now do Tuesdays and Thursdays because Sundays I'm now doing a masterclass for February. So we'll keep this Tuesday, Thursday schedule for the last 2 weeks. So before I actually started tonight, I wanted to know if anyone, I'll open the chat. I don't know if you want to put it in the chat, if you want to actually talk. Has anyone seen a change? We have a new routine. We got a new hobby. We implemented self-care. We're on a budget. We had any kind of breakthrough. Does anyone want to share anything that they have accomplished thus far in the challenge? Let me open the chat.
I have.
Okay.
I've seen a difference. I've been going to the gym, manifesting more, meeting with my accountability partner.
Okay.
Once a week, and we keep each other on track with our goals. Getting rid of, you know, some of those procrastination habits.
Mm-hmm.
Mindset improving.
Awesome, awesome. Did we all get a chance?
I also have.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes, ever since I broke that plate, something happened. And for example, today I got my first TikTok sale.
Okay, come on. First sale, yes.
And I just show up every day. I'm just showing up every day.
What are you selling?
Well, this was a trading log. So it's a journal for day traders.
Okay.
And I also have a 100 days of self-love daily journal and planner.
Okay.
To help with managing time.
Okay. And so you are just creating content on TikTok?
Yes. Well, I have a KDP account where I've been creating low content books and then advertising it on TikTok.
Okay. So how did you feel when you got your first TikTok sale?
I was like, ooh, I got to step it up. I got to be prepared. It's about to start, you know? And now I'm thinking, and I can remember you saying, stay prepared.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to get ready.
Because right.
Now I need to go and get the correct mailers. And
right.
I need to get into the business, masterclass.
Okay. Well, yeah. If you go on, I'm having my next one. Sunday is Super Bowl. So the next one's going to be on Monday. Okay. Anyone else want to share? You're welcome. Congratulations on your sale. And, am I saying your name right? Rosario?
Yeah.
Congratulations on your accountability partner and, you know, staying on track. I know it's hard, you know, starting a new habit, you know, and it's easy to fall off. So congratulations on, you know, getting your accountability partner and really, you know, putting in the work with the manifestation. That is awesome.
Yeah, I think going through the stages of dealing with loss, pain, and heartache, and like going through all of the steps 1 through 6, that and then finding where we are in all of that, or where I have been, because my story resonates with you, with like your divorce and abuse and all of that, and so I've had to deal with all of that, but finding where I was in that, and then writing. And then, you know, letting go of everything, but then being able to move forward with it and find a new path, I think is just really, really brought clarity to, like, the journey that I need to be on and the journey that I want to go on.
Right.
And then also, like, it really did kind of help me be able to even be motivated to go and look at that house that I wanted or live in that neighborhood that I wanted to live in and go and look at the vehicles and clean my car, go and wash my car. Me and my accountability partner, we were laughing at that, and both of us were like, did you clean your car? And we both cleaned our car really well.
So. Awesome.
So it's just like the little steps to find where you are in that stage that really do help and make a difference.
Awesome. Anyone else want to share? I see in the chat, CL put more gym, saving more, and I'm eating dinner. Okay, CL, I see you. So I was supposed to do the plate, but I never got around to going to Dollar Tree to get the plate. But I have like a deep freezer in my garage, and I just had too much food in it. So long story short, I unplugged it because it was full of ice, and I wanted to clean it out, but I forgot that I had unplugged it. So it had been unplugged for about 2 weeks, and I didn't realize until I went in my garage and there was a smell. I had all this ice cream and, you know, dairy stuff all on my garage, so that I had to clean out. Okay. So for those who don't know, going through a divorce, husband took the business over. And so when I first moved here, we had a uniform at the dealership. So I had a whole bunch of our branded sweatshirts. I had hats, I had jackets, and I was like, I'm holding on. This is my dealership, and boom, 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 boom. And so maybe about 2 months ago, I had cleaned out my closet. And I said, you know what, Joy? I am past this stage of holding on to the business. I'm going to let the lawyers handle it. Whatever is the settlement, it is what it is. But I need to let go of some of the paraphernalia. So I kind of gave a good chunk of it to the Goodwill. But for, I don't know why, I kept some of the jackets. This is not it. It's a different name. I kept some of the jackets and I kept some of the shirts. I don't know why, just because. So fast forward to my deep freezer being unplugged, the ice cream melting all out on the garage floor. It now smells. It was too much for a paper towel. I didn't want to use one of my real towels. And I happened to look over, and what is there? My jacket from the garage. And something said, just clean this mess up with the jacket. And so it's a nice jacket, but it's like I took the jacket, I started cleaning the floor up with the jacket, then behind the jacket was a sweatshirt and then two polos. So I ended up cleaning my entire garage floor with the jackets, but it felt so good. It felt like I was just releasing, like I am over this divorce. I am over, you know, I want to just move on, focus on everything that I have going on now. Then whatever happens with that happens. So that's my story of my let it go plate. It wasn't a plate, but it was, you know, a jacket. But the same scenario of I just felt something in my system, just like letting go of the deal. Like it is over. It's letting it go. And so I just feel like a weight has been lifted off my shoulders. Okay. So tonight, since we went through, let me go through our homework. Our last time we met, we were going through the different stages of dealing with grief. And so I'll do a recap. So first it's shock. Then you are, let me just find it on my phone because it's too small on that screen.
Managing denial.
Okay, thank you.
Self-blame.
Okay.
Handling heartache and then welcoming anger and arriving at acceptance.
Okay. So those are going to be the five stages of handling grief. So whether it is grief in a personal relationship, at the job, losing a friend, losing a job, whatever it is, those are the stages. And when you know where you are in the process and then you know where you have to go, it kind of gives you a path. That's going to lead to what I want to call are going to be the seasons of life. Everyone, no matter who you are, what you got going on, there are different seasons of life, and we're in the same, it's going to be the same seasons of life. The first season is going to be the planting season. The planting season is when you are just planting seeds. Nothing is sprouting out. You're just putting in a whole bunch of work, hoping that something works out. Okay, that's the planting season. When you plant a seed, if I were to go outside on my driveway, plant a seed, will it grow sitting on the driveway cement? No. A seed has to be planted in the ground, covered over with dirt, and then fertilized, watered, the whole nine. So it has to be in the dark, okay? It has to be in the dark for it to grow. So our first season is going to be the planting season. The second season is going to be your dark season. when you're in your dark season, everything that can go wrong is going wrong. Okay? If it goes from bad to worse to worser. Nothing seems to be happening right. You keep getting, you take one step forward and two steps back. Everything that used to work is no longer working. This is your dark season, okay? But in order for the seed to grow, it has to be planted. It has to go through the dark to then what? Now we have our harvest season. Your harvest season is where the money is just flowing to you. The opportunity is just coming. Everywhere you turn, there's good news. There's this. It's like you can't do anything wrong. That's going to be your harvest season. And then we go right back to our planting season. So just like the seasons in for the weather, it's not going to be cold all year. It's not going to be hot all year. You're going to have winter, then you're going to have spring, then you're going to have summer, then you're going to have fall. The seasons don't last forever. That's going to be the same for the seasons of life. Each season will not last forever, but you're going to go through those three seasons constantly. For some reason, we think that when bad things happen, when we get bad news, when things don't go how we expect them to be, that something is wrong. Why is this happening to me? Our life is never going to be just straight. It's going to be ups and downs and ups and downs and ups and downs. So just like it's great to understand the different stages of dealing with grief, loss, anger, whatever the case is, it's great to understand the three seasons of life for this reason. When you are in your harvest season, everywhere you turn is this opportunity. You're just stepping over money. Everything is just prosperous. And when I talk about these seasons, we have seasons in our personal relationships, and then we're going to have it in our finances, okay? I could be having the best personal, I could be in my harvest season in my personal relationships, but I could be in my dark season in my finances, okay? But I need you to understand these are seasons for this reason. When I'm in my harvest season, I'm enjoying it. I'm thanking God, oh my gosh, you know, I've been working for X amount of time. I've been planting these seeds. It's finally coming to fruition. When I get back into a season where I'm planting, I'm doing the same work, but I'm not seeing the same results, I understand I'm in my planting season. If you're at a new job, you understand that I have to come early, stay late. I got to put extra work in to get recognized before I can get a promotion because I'm new. When you have your business and you're starting out, you're just trying to make something shake. You're just trying this and that and that and this, but you're putting the seeds. The seeds is I'm showing up every day. I'm putting in the work. I'm going in early. I'm staying late. I'm not taking no for an answer. I'm just planting seeds, as many as possible, because I just want something to grow. When we get in our dark season and we go from bad news to bad news to bad news, we don't need to worry. Oh my gosh, what's happening to me? You need to know I'm in my dark season. Let me brace myself for impact. Right now in this season, I'm going to get some bad news. Things are not going to go how I want them to go. My business may be stagnant for the next 90 days. Me and my best friend, if it's personal, maybe we are just, you know, not seeing eye to eye. Or maybe, you know, we haven't been able to see each other, whatever the case may be. But once you realize you're in that dark season, stop wishing, well, how come I'm not winning and the girl over here, she's just having all this opportunity? What's wrong with me? Nothing's wrong with you. You're in your harvest season. So when you're in your harvest season, you know right now is not the time for splurging. Right now it's not going to be the time for me to have all these wins. Right now, God has me planted. He has me in the dark for a reason. What we need to be focusing on when we're in the dark is, what is the lesson? Why is God covering me? Why is God hiding me? What am I supposed to be learning from this? If we're in our dark season, just woe is me, I'm a victim, I don't get the same opportunity, no, 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 no. We're not learning anything that God's supposed to be showing us. But once again, it is just a season. So I know I got to just hold on. I got to just hold on. Things will change. I'm not looking for increase. I'm not looking for growth. I am just looking to maintain, to hold steady. If it's business-wise, let me just break even. I'm not looking to go to another location. I'm not looking to expand. I'm not looking to double my profit. Because right now, I'm in my dark season. Maybe I'm in, I'll give you an example. When gas was forever high last year, if I was in transportation, that wouldn't be the time for me to go and buy 10 more trucks. That's not the time to expand my business because my industry is saying I'm going to take a hit right now. I may be taking a loss because of the cost of gas is eating into my profits. I don't need to quit. I don't need to go say, well, screw this trucking. I'm done. I can't make a profit. I understand. I'm in my dark season. Let me just maintain. Let me just hold steady. Let me kind of minimize my bleed. But it's just a season. So whenever you go through your dark periods, if you understand it's just a season. Now, I can't tell you if it's going to be a two-week season, a two-month season, a six-month season. No one can tell you how long that season is. But as long as you do whatever you need to do to hold steady and stay positive, don't be shocked when you get bad news after bad news after bad news. I'm in my dark season. When you have that mindset, you understand eventually things are going to change. And then when they change, after the dark is the harvest. Once that seed is planted and it starts to grow, now you have your harvest season. But you can only have a harvest that relates to whatever, how many seeds you planted. I can't plant two seeds and expect my harvest season to just be banging because I only planted two seeds. Now, in my planting season, if I'm out here turning over every leaf, turning over every tree, doing everything I can to plant as many seeds, and I get to my dark season, once I hit my harvest season, it's going to be insane. But once again, I'm planning for that dark season. And this is going to be continuous. It's the same three seasons. It's going to be in your business or your financial life. And you're going to have it in your personal life. You could be in your harvest season personally and professionally, or you could be in different seasons personally and professionally. But you, as long as you understand, it's just a season. When I'm going through my divorce, I'm not looking to find love 2 weeks later. I'm not looking to have all the answers because I know, oh, this is going to be dark. When I got all that bad news, taking the money out, taking over the business, I got to do all of this. Okay, God, this is going to be a real dark season. Let me brace for impact. I'm not looking for the win right now. I'm looking to maintain. What am I maintaining? How do I maintain my mentality? How do I maintain my mindset? How do I not fall into anxiety? How do I not fall into depression? What do I need to do to make sure that my son's okay? How am I going to be able to survive right now in this season? I'm not at the dealership talking about I need to go ahead and trade in this paid off car and go ahead and get me a note. I don't know what's going on financially. I'm not looking to go on no vacation right now. I'm in my dark season. So I am going to be pouring more into myself for self-care. I'm pouring into myself mentally. I'm reading books. I'm listening to YouTube videos. I am just trying to minimize my bleed and hold steady. Me and my son, we're not going to turn up at Disneyland. Right? That's not that season. I'm finding little small stuff for us to do for us to still have fun, but I understand it's just a season. My life isn't over. I'm not going to die in this same situation. It's just a season. But eventually, and maybe the harvest season comes all at once, or it may be small things that God starts to give you. Even in your dark season, he's going to give you a little sunshine. It may rain 6 days out the week. On one day, he's going to give you a little glimpse. You're going to have some relief on that anxiety. You're going to have a little bit of good news. You may not have no good news, but you may be able to see your way out. It's pouring down, it's rain, but if I look and I squint far, close enough and I look far enough, I see a little light at the end of the tunnel. And while we're in that dark season, we're just looking for a little positivity. Just a little sign that God's giving us to keep on going, that he has us. I'm not looking for nothing big. I know I'm in my dark season. And then once again, we get into the harvest. Now, if we're in our harvest season financially, we need to be mindful that, baby, once again, this is just a season. So it works with the bad and it works with the good. So in my harvest season in my business, everywhere I turn, I am bumping into money. I am bumping into opportunity. I can't stop the sales. Like, the sales keep coming and coming and coming. I'm at Publix doing just shopping, and I'm running into someone who wants to partner with me. I'm getting people are just contacting me out the blue to do boom, boom, boom. Oh my gosh, life is so great. Yes, it is. It's just a season. You better put some money away, because you know after this is back to the plannings in the dark. Make some wise decisions, because we're going to get back in the dark. A lot of times we think once we get our win, woo, that's it. Life is not a destination. It's a journey. And we're always up and down and up and down and up and down. What changes is us. When we get back in that down, when we get back in that dark, when you've already gone through the dark and you came out, you already know, oh, okay, I already know what this is. So now when I'm in my dark, I may not be making the same amount of money, but now I'm still thanking God and praising God. Ooh, God, thank you that I broke even today. Ooh, God, I didn't make no sales today, but thank you that I was able to learn something new. Thank you I was able to still network today. I haven't got my business started, but I'm two steps closer. I had a dream last night, and I think he showed me a vision to try something else. I haven't had any sales in a while, but I came up with a new marketing plan. I'm going to try that. When you're in your dark, you're just looking for the small things to keep you going, the small little wins. We're not looking for the home runs. See, sometimes in sports, I may not need a three-pointer. I may just need, yes, go ahead.
I want to know, like, okay, so in the dark season, like I'm in the dark season, I feel like right now, right? For me, it's all about like, and I saw that Shayla put routines, like getting into routines. Like, I know to get out of the dark season, you have to have a routine, or like you have to have like little steps to try to get out of the dark season, because it's not just going to happen without any kind of action, you know? So for me, it's like, how do you get your mind wrapped around it to take those little steps and get out of the procrastination? Like, I just got off of watching Mel Robbins talking about like getting out of procrastination and, you know, getting out of the dark season. Because when you have like all of this stress, you start procrastinating, and then that hinders like the growth and the planting more seeds and the harvest and all of that, you know. But like, what do you do? Because you inspire me to do better. All the time. Like, I'm always watching you and I'm just like, how does she do it? How does she, like, I can't even fathom like all of the businesses and everything that you went through and I'm kind of going through right now, and just trying to figure out like the little steps to come out of the dark season, you know?
The first thing I would say is you got to have a why. Okay. So you're in the dark. What are you trying to get out to do? What are you trying to get out to become? What is that why? So when all this happened to me, my why was, I got to have my son in something that's stable. I have to be healthy and stable to have something stable for my son. My son is not going to see me broken. He's not going to see mommy crying. I can't just lay down and then have nothing. And then number three, Whenever I cross my path, or whenever my ex sees me again, he won't see me where he left me. I'm not gonna be at the same spot. And then last but not least, I was like, you know, Joy, you need to go be the best you can be. Because I have, when you're, I had just been, I was not joy. I was just dimming my light. I was, you know, being, I was not being me to make someone else feel like they were, my husband competed with me in everything. I didn't have a partner. It's always a competition. So I'm always, quote unquote, let me let him win this race because I'm trying to be submissive. I don't have someone that can say, oh my God, I'm so proud of you. You're good in this and I'm good at that. And together it was always a competition. So let me just stop running because everything I do touches gold and it bothers this person. I was tired of being that person. So I have to now go make something shake. If I stay here and I stay sad, how am I going to provide for my son? Who am I going to be? So one, start with a why. Number two, who do you want to be? What is that person? And write out who is the woman that you want to be. So when I left, I was on this strict diet. To me, I was too skinny. I said, I want to be more in shape. I want to have more muscles. I said, I want to be happy. I want to be the girl I was before I got married. I want to be, you know, wearing cute clothes, wearing makeup. I'm going to be a wife again. He's going to treat me like a princess. So I started to become the woman that I wanted to be. And I wanted this man, and I wrote down all the things I wanted in my husband. And then I wanted to still be a boss. I wrote down all of these things that I wanted my business to be as my mama is paying my rent. So how am I going to make six figures a month? Well, I'm going to have to sell this, this, and this. Well, let me first start selling one product. Let me start selling one product and get that thing going. How am I going to make myself known on social media? I need to show up my best self. I'm not going to be on camera teaching and I'm not going to have on makeup. I'm not going to have my hair. I'm going to show up like a businesswoman will show up. I wouldn't go to court, you know, with no makeup on and hat. Let me show up on that. On my personal side, I need to be a princess. So a princess is going to have her car clean whenever because I used to run out on errands in a t-shirt and just like, no. If I'm going to be a princess acts a certain way. I went to Old Navy, Forever 21, got Aaron clothes, little leggings, a cute little crop top, a little jean. Every time I step out, I'm looking like who I want to be. I'm still broken. I don't know where March rent's gonna go. But I am living a life that I want to have. And then slowly, and every day, in the beginning, all day, I'm listening to Keon Henderson, T.D. Jakes on YouTube. I mean, I'm in my office and that's playing all day. Because I know if I lose my mind, I'm going to lose everything. So I got to keep that. For me, I had to keep all that positivity all night. I'm putting YouTube on as I'm going to bed, as I'm sleeping. I had to keep that just in me 24/7. Because I was in that anger resentment phase. Like, I want to catch a flight and go burn all this shit down. That's where I was, okay? I'm going to burn this shit down. That's where I was. So I'm a baby Christian. So I know who you... It's just take a baby step. If you're stuck, what are two things you're going to do every single day that's going to be a routine? Are you walking every day? Are you getting up and putting some makeup on? Are you listening to you? What are you going to do? Just pick two things every single day. And then once you get accustomed to doing those two things, add you one more. Or if you dark, what's one thing you're going to do every single day to help you in this rut? To help you either help your mentality or to help who you need to become. So how you were saying you had your car cleaned? Well, for this month, I'm going to make sure that my car is cleaned every week. I'm going to make sure that I am reading a book or whatever. Just pick two or three things that you're going to do every single week for yourself. And then after you get accustomed to that, then add on one more. And then add on one more. But my focus was, where am I going? I had the 86, my life, all them cars, that big old house. Cause my whole thing was I worked so hard to get to where I was. I was finally at a space where bills are on auto pay. I have a great lifestyle. I'm not tripping. And now I got to start from ground zero. This is not fair. If I am divorcing at this age and all this work, I should be able to take 3 months off and just gather myself and go to the spa. That's how I saw my divorce process happening. But God said, no, that's not what I have for you. You have to get right back up here and work. Now, I don't know why I had to do it that way, but that it is what it is. So I can't complain about it. I can't cry about it. So I had everywhere around my house, on my computer, on my refrigerator, my bathroom mirror. I got quotes written on my wall. I got how much I want to make. I have a post and I want to make X amount a month in my business. A Christian loving husband has found me. Everything I wanted is posted all around. So although, baby, I'm everywhere mentally, I'm always seeing something positive or hearing something just to kind of keep me just grounded. And then over time, I would realize, oh, I don't need to listen to the YouTube video all day long just to get through the day. I still kept it on, but hey, I'm finding happiness in small things. Let me now go make a new life. Well, what's my new life? Let me go try this hobby. I'll try that hobby. Let me go put my son in every sport there was so he's active. So he don't realize his daddy ain't coming to see him. His daddy ain't really calling him. Let me kind of keep him busy because he don't know all what's really going on. But if you don't do what I did. You just do what you feel you need to do for the first, just take that first step. And every day, God, help me get rid of whatever is the emotion. Help me get rid of the sadness. Help me get rid of the resentment. Help me get rid of the anger. Lord, show me why I'm going through a divorce. Show me why this is happening. And when you ask God to show you, he will show you. So when I ask God, why is this happening? And then I get shot at. And then you take the money out. And then you lock the business. Oh, I'm not really losing anything. Bam. Now I got to handle the resentment. Who this nigga think he is? When I met him, he didn't have no. He got me all the way. No. But if I stay here, this ain't making no money. I'ma be a bitter woman. I'ma be stuck. I'm missing out on me being mad is missing out on my blessing. How do I get rid of the resentment? And Keon Henderson had a sermon on. I said, God, please help me get rid of the resentment. I'm brushing my teeth. I done left YouTube on. And Keon Henderson popped up on a sermon about how he went through divorce and how he dealt with resentment. I said, now, God, if you don't come on through. And from there, I went and listened to every sermon he had. Because it's like, that was the person that was talking to me. I'm a TDJ's person, but Keon Henderson was talking to me in this season. But it's not going to happen tomorrow. It's not going to happen in these 30 days. But slowly but surely, you're going to feel a little better. You're going to be less sad. You're going to be less mad. But keep your focus on what is your new life? Who are you about to become now? What are you planning on having? What are you working towards? So I'm working towards my goal. I'm working towards getting joy together. I'm always going to show up for joy. My son needs to be able to ask for nothing that I can't do. If this little $700 I get, if it come, it don't come, I don't care. I don't need it. I need to get to where I don't need nobody but joy. And God got me there. Baby, can you keep the baby? Keep the money. Keep a little $700. I ain't going to do nothing.
That's where I'm at the arriving at acceptance stage.
Okay.
And just like wanting to, now I've set my goals, and me and my accountability partner, we went over our vision board and went over all of the things that we want to do. And I do want to get to $1 million by the end of the year. I feel everything that you're saying is so true. Where I was left is not where I will be at the end of the year, and just really praying for that and manifesting it. I think for me, I kind of get stuck though. How do I get there? You know, the steps on how to arrive there. Cause that is what everything that you're saying is what I want. It's just how do I get there? But everything that you're saying, it makes sense, you know, just
so
every single day.
Do you work a 9-to-5 or you have a business?
No, I'm an entrepreneur.
Okay. So are you focused on growing the business, or you're trying to get over the emotions from going through the divorce? Are you working on both?
Yeah, so you know how business and divorce gets really mixed up, and so then all everything gets taken away, everything gets frozen, and you know, somebody takes all your money, everything that you're saying, and then just trying to start from ground zero. I'm in a brand new place, a lifestyle that is so unfamiliar to me, and I trying to start over has been really, really hard. So I started my company about 12 years ago, and it hasn't been the same for the last year. So I'm trying to get back up. But when I look at it, you know, and I'm just man, I worked so hard to get to where I was, and then everything just gone.
So
and starting all fresh again.
We have to let that go.
Mm-hmm.
We can't look back. It's not fair. You shouldn't have to do it. It is what it is.
Yeah. But it is what it is, and that's the acceptance.
So we don't know why. But besides Keon Henderson, turn on Steve Harvey. When God closes one door, he's opened up a bigger door. Now, you can keep focus on, what I had and why this. As long as you keep looking back as to what you had, you're robbing yourself of what God has for you. Because what if God said what you had was too small? That's why I closed the door. What you had wasn't what your destiny was. That's why I closed the door. God closed the season. He closed it for a reason. So my whole thing was, let me find the reason that he closed it. I don't know why he closed it, but now I'm focusing on, let me go pay my rent. I got to pay my rent, these lights. I know I need an X amount of money. I got to go work my online business to get X amount of money. And by month 2, he quadrupled what I was trying to get. And that's when I said, oh my gosh, this selling digital products works. Got it. That's all I needed. I'm about to run this to the ground. I just need to know, what lane am I in? Once I get my lane, I'm good. But what lane am I? If you scroll all the way down my Instagram page, I'm going to be on a whiteboard. I'm doing 8-minute videos. It takes you a while to zig and zag it to get where you're supposed to be. So you're starting your business all the way over. Okay, so what new technique are we going to do? What new marketing style are we going to do? Try A on Monday, try B on Tuesday, try C on Wednesday. What do the people like? We're now going to create a brand new baby. Let the past go. Let them 12 years go. They're over with. God has something bigger and better for you. You have to just go down the hall. He done closed that door. Stop knocking on it. We're going to go focus on, where am I going to go down now in down the hall to where God, he closed it for a reason. So we don't know what that reason is. We can't worry about the reason, but God, you closed it. Help me find what my new lane is. So we're just every day praying that God shows you what's the new lane. Is this the business you're supposed to be in? Should you maybe do something else? Maybe have another lane in? Like, find out what that new thing is. Think about birthing a baby. You now have the opportunity to now go and become anything you want to be. What do you want to be? But if we're starting brand new, okay, I got to start this. I got to start it. So my goal shouldn't be, I get $1 million is the end goal. Give yourself a 30-day goal. Can I make $5,000 from this business? Can I make $3,000 from this? First, let me see what can I make from this? The $1 million just comes from whatever's working. I now scale it. If I can get 10 people to buy my ebook, I made $100 for the day. Bet. 10 people want it. All I got to go do now is scale it. If I had 10 people buy it, how do I get 20 people to buy it? Oh, I got to post 2 times a day. Bam. I posted 2 times a day every single month and 20 people buy my thing a day. How do I get to 30 people? Let me post this and I'll post on Facebook. But you got to first find what's the small formula. You can get to the million. How do you make $100 or $1,000? And from that, we just scale it. I just need more, but I got to first find out what's working. But I kept in my mind, whatever I made back there, I wanted my monthly income there to be my daily income. So my whole thing was, whatever litigation gets done, because at first I was holding on. Every court date, I'm thinking I'm about to be vindicated. They gonna see and na-na-na-na, and it gets reset. And then we got a receiver in there. Now we got a forensic account, and then we're on fifth motion to compel. And I said, I can't keep holding on. I'm trying to get vindicated. Forget being vindicated. Let that go. Go get your own win. I said, I'm going to make so much money in this new thing that when I finally get my settlement, it's just going to go into a trust for dues. Here, eventually he's going to need some money. I'm not going to be worried about it. So you want to reset, Judd? I'm not tripping on the reset. I pay for all these tickets. God blessed me with the money for the tickets. I had a deposition with my son's father, and we're passing all the documents, and his response is, I can't read. So I flew me, my brother, and my son, hotel, rental car, for us to have a 15-minute deposition, because I married someone who's ignorant, right? And his response was, I can't read. So the court reporter's like, well, what you mean you can't? He said, oh, I can't read. 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 All that in... embarrassing. So don't worry about the baby. If this case goes on for three, baby, it can go on forever. Am I mad that I spent money on plane? God gave me the money to pay for it. I could have not had the money to be out here. He provided for me. Thank you, God. I know God says he gonna give you 10 times whatever you lost. So baby, whenever it hits. But I'm so focused on getting my win now. You just go win. Whatever you made a month there, your goal is, I'm going to make that in a day. I'm going to win so big that whatever was the back here is going to be something small. You're going to just put it in a savings account somewhere and just, you know, sit it down somewhere. You're not even tripping on it. Get your mentality there. So get your business. Get you your small wins. How do you make $100 or $1,000 a day? What is that formula? That's how we start. What do the people want? What's the proof of concept? What's your target audience? Are we sitting here professional doing videos? Do they want to have fun videos? Are we doing, are you trying to work on doing some collabs, right? So find someone else that has an ancillary product, right? That may not be in your same industry, but a person like her may use your product or service. Hey, can we do a live together? Can I do a joint venture? So now, you know, your business and you are being seen in front of their audience. Start networking on social media. You ain't got to go nowhere. Be on Facebook, be on TikTok, get on Instagram, and just start networking with people. Hey, you want to collab and do a live together? I talk about my thing, and no. And you got to get your business to know what is the product or service or the combo that can give me $1,000. Once you get that, all we got to do is this scale. I just need more people to give me that $1,000. But have you a small goal to achieve first? Then once you get that small goal, now we double it. And we just going to just double and then double and then double and then double. And then you're going to look up and you're going to be, oh my gosh, how did I get here? But you have to let all that in. You have to just let it go. Go get you another plate, girl, and go crash it again. But no, God closed the door for a reason. He got something bigger and better.
I can feel it. I can feel it. I can see it. Because I do have the motivation. I think everybody here in this room has a goal. I mean, we wouldn't be here if we didn't.
Correct.
You know? But it's, yeah, I agree. It's finding that why, like, what is it? What, you know, for me, I'm in a state of like transformation of who is it that I want to be now, you know, compared to who I was in my marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I want to go through this whole transformation, like with my look, my clothes, my money, my style, like all of it, like I can feel it, like letting go of all of that, putting that on the plate and just crushing it, like everything that I was, that no longer exists.
Correct.
And I do truly do feel that way at this point, like at the stage of acceptance. And it does feel really good, but I just got to get out of that dark spot of and finding like the direction that I need to go.
So make it like a fun thing. I'm trying to figure out where I'm like, what my next move is.
Mm-hmm.
And then I would say gratitude, right? So I am happy that I have a roof over my head. I could be, you know, starting brand new at my mama's house. At least I have my own place, right? I have gratitude. You know, I can't Uber Eats every single day. You know, we're on a budget, but on the weekends, dudes, we can Uber Eats, you know. But during the week, you know, I am cooking every day. I haven't cooked almost a day in my life. I never cooked in my marriage. I don't cook. I'm not a good cook. We ate out every single day. So a lot of things change. So, okay, I'm going to act like I'm back in college. You know, in college, you are at Walmart, you know, with that great value or Equate. You know, I put my mindset is, it's like I'm back in college. I barely have some furniture. I'm on Facebook Marketplace. My son has the furniture from the basement and a bed frame from Facebook Marketplace. Like, we didn't have no furniture. I just remember my mama paid my rent in February. My house is the size of my bedroom, right? So I went from drastic, baby. Like, whoa, this is different. But hey, I ain't tripping. My last name ain't Gates. I didn't grow up with a trust fund. You know what I'm saying, girl? Go back to your, I made it fun. Go back to your college days. When your parents gave you money, you went to the club and got an outfit. Now you got to figure out food for the next week. Made it fun. All right, well, how we gonna thug it out this week? I made it fun. I ain't tripping. I'm not worried about it. I'm not worried about no furniture. I'm trying to pay my rent and have me a little extra money for Deuce to have an Amazon treat and Uber Eats. And I'm good. My expectation, I'm not gonna get it back tomorrow. So don't have that expectation to get it back. I'm not going to get it back. I'm not trying to get it back. So I'm lifestyle. But that's the past. I can't worry about that. I'm starting brand new. So I go from like, I can't do Uber Eats on the weekend. Oh, and now we can do Uber Eats during the week. Look at God. We can Uber Eats. Dude, you want Uber Eats? I'm thankful for the small stuff. I ain't tripping about being broke. I've been broke before. I can be broke again. It ain't nothing new. We're going to just make it fun. But you keep thinking about what you use. But baby, you ain't got that. So I'm going to appreciate that I can Uber Eats twice this week and not just once. Ain't God good? As long as you turn it into gratitude, God going to keep blessing you. But make it into, I'm starting all over. Like I'm a freshman in college. We going to get it how we get it.
That's exactly what it feels like, too. Just starting all over.
It's all over. But hey,
starting all over.
I could be starting over having a walk. I could be starting over at a homeless shelter. I could be starting over and the bullet hit me and messed up my face or killed me. I could be starting over and the bullet ricocheted and killed my son. So I focus on how the stuff could have been worse. I'm healthy. He's healthy. I got a roof over my head. I don't have no furniture. I ain't got nothing. So, hey, I'm going to make it do what it do. And just slowly but surely, I'm not even worried about furniture. I'm trying to make my rent and Uber Eats and have do something on his Amazon. He has to be as consistent as possible. I'm not shopping. I'm not buying no mail. I'm not even looking to shop. I'm starting from ground zero. So when you at ground zero, you can't do all what you used to do. But I know it's only a season. If I did it before, I can do it again. If you built your business before and you don't have a brain tumor, you can still think and function, you can do it again, right? So just go do it again.
It's different. I think the direction too that I want to go in is more modern money. Whereas like before, like my company that I owned wasn't on social media. You know, it was more like private business, mm-hmm. You know, business to business. So my whole transformation now and who I want to be has more to do with like modern money and social media and like the direction that you're in. So that's a whole new thing. So for me, it's just all about like I've been learning and investing in myself and taking classes and like doing this like mentorship and all of that. And I think like part of divorce, like that's really important for me, is transforming also like my mindset and the direction of finances that I want to go into, mm-hmm. because there is a lot of money in modern money. Online money.
So yeah, classes, you know, learning, following different people who are doing what you're doing what you're wanting to do, seeing how they market, how can you put your own spin on it, and just trying different things until you find your like what works for you. Mm-hmm. But if they can do it, you can do it, right? They ain't smarter than you.
Yeah.
So just give yourself a grace period of like pretend that you're a freshman. You're not going to graduate next year. You're just a freshman. You got to go to be a freshman, sophomore, junior. I think if you just keep your expectations in, let me just get through freshman. Let me just get to what I'm doing, how I'm marketing it, what's my target audience, how am I doing this? Bam, once you get that done, now we can run with it. But don't try to run right now. Just try to kind of get your foundation together as to what you're doing new in your business. Because the online space is totally different than brick and mortar. Mm-hmm. So when you're going into a whole different industry, you now got to learn the industry, learn the ins and outs. Like that, and that's a process. But here's the good thing. You already have another industry or another business that you can start. What if you're like, I have no idea what I want to do?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you, Joy.
You're welcome, girl.
You're such an inspiration.
Girl, I'm not. I'm just, you know. I'm just here, girl. I'm just here.
You're doing your thing.
Anyone else got any questions? I want to say something. Let me look in the chat. So
I have a question.
Go ahead, girl.
The planting season, like if you don't plant, does that delay everything if you just don't believe that you deserve it or won't make a decision? You know, like, you might know what you want to do with business, but your personal life, you might, you know, I'm going through that with, as far as making my 3 and 5 year goals. I can't even really see that far.
Okay. So if you can't see that far, start where you can see. Do you have 1 year goals?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Well, let's just focus on those 1 year goals.
Okay.
And then if you don't feel like you deserve it, do you have the self-confidence workbook?
I do.
Okay. So I will go through that. You could try to find someone on YouTube to talk about self-confidence, but baby, you are 101. You are custom made. Can't nobody do it like you do it.
Mm-hmm.
You are you, and that is your superpower. So if God made you and no one else has your fingerprint, and he made you exactly how he wanted you to be, because he don't make no mistakes, and why do you not feel like you just deserve everything?
I think it's just old beliefs, because I can resonate with what you're saying, and I just need to stay looking in that direction and just continue to remember that, because I think it, because it doesn't even make sense when you say that about the fingerprint and, you know, I do have a relationship with God. Me not deserving it doesn't even really make sense. So it has to be just an old thing that needs to just be released, you know?
So go back to your plate, girl, write that down. And then I would have some affirmations that I'm saying every single day to make sure that you understand that you are that chick and can't no one touch you, period.
Okay.
And the Bible says you have not because you ask not. So he didn't say, well, you have to have a college degree from here to ask for something. And for you to have, you have not because you ask not. So why are you scared to ask? You deserve it, baby. If he woke you up this morning, he has a plan for you. Maybe you can try to find what is your gift? What is your purpose? What do you do the best with the least amount of effort?
I think it's motivating and coaching, just from being a mom and, you know.
You have a son or a daughter?
Both.
So do you tell them that they can be anything that they want to be?
In so many words, you know, I just kind of like coach them along. If I see something that they're doing that they need to shift or need to improve on, then I'm behind them on that. I'm helping them to be accountable,
mm-hmm.
you know, and motivating them. And I have a vision for them, so I'm helping them to see the vision that I have for them. And I like the feeling of if somebody else helping others, you know, see that in their own life.
So how can you help others see that, but you don't see it in yourself?
Yeah.
Because for you to be a good coach, a good coach has to lead with experience.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say whatever is causing you to doubt yourself, we need to heal that wound. I don't know what experience you had in life that makes you feel like your kids can be everything and your clients can be everything, but you can't be everything. You see how that's like a contradiction?
Mm-hmm.
So if they can be everything, then that means you can be everything. And your kids are going to do what you do, not what you say. So if they see you second guessing yourself and limiting what you expect for yourself, they're going to be like, well, mommy, you don't think blah, blah, blah. So why do you think I should do blah, blah, blah?
Mm-hmm.
So I would say positive affirmations every single day. So that you can learn that, you know, you are the bomb, baby. Just how you are. Because God made you just how you are. And he don't make no mistakes.
Okay.
Period. And whoever else says otherwise, next. They're just not your person. That's not your friend. That's not your target audience. Move around.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, let's see. Miss Locks by Latish. Am I saying your name right?
Close.
Latish. Okay, how you doing, Miss Latish?
I'm doing great. This was right up my alley. I needed this. You said something when you were talking to Rosario about finding collaborations on social media, right? And one of the things that I'm leery about when it comes to that is because I'm not really social media savvy, and it's like now you can buy who is actually real versus who's fake, to know who I can and cannot collaborate with. Does that make any sense? And so I was just wondering if anyone could give me some sort of idea on how to verify if, you know, this is like an actual real with a real profile, this AC with this entity.
Well, I would just say just contact them, you know, and if they're talking back to you and they're going to do a live with you, someone has to pop up on that screen, right? I'm not saying pay anyone. I'm saying just do a collab, like we're going to just do something together. What locks by, so are you, you do locks?
Yes, I have my natural hair salon. And my niche is locks, but we do all sorts of natural hair. But yes.
Where are you located?
I am in Maryland, so in Baltimore.
And you're in Baltimore?
Yes.
Okay. So if you do locks in Baltimore, do you sell any kind of products or we're just doing the service?
I am in the process right now looking at two these to help me create my product. So,
okay.
So that I can bring in another form of income. I also have vendor so that I can now my shelving so that I can get my hair on myself to get that'll be another source of income. But I'm looking for a braiding vendor, so I do have I want to be able to have other streams of income while I'm still establishing the salon as a whole.
Okay.
I also have reached out to someone. I'm supposed to be
it's kind of staticky, but go ahead.
Okay. I also have, I did do one kind of natural perfumes and candles. It's like a whole natural hair and natural aesthetic. I'm going to have candles and colognes also. I actually ordered those. And I'm just getting my display together for that also.
Okay, so if you're doing locks, you want to be known as the lock girl, okay? So content would be if you're doing your client's hair, you know, showing that. You need to be showing up every single day. So as you're getting dressed in the morning, throw your little camera up there. How are you styling your locks? You should be doing videos on how do you maintain your locks? What are the different types of locks? How do you, like, what if your locks get, you know, dreaded and, you know, and tangled? Can you color locks? If you're looking for a stream of income, why don't you sell an ebook, right? Won't cost you a lot of money. Sell you an ebook on lock maintenance. So if I am new to locking my hair, how do I lock my hair? What's the process? What are your top five products or whatever products you suggest on putting on hair if you're just trying to lock it, and have a link to those products on Amazon, or if you sell them or where they go. If you are already have locks, how do you maintain them? If you color your locks, what should be the maintenance for that? So now, although you're in Baltimore, you can now sell this ebook to anyone in the USA that has locks. How many people are walking around here with dry locks, with dandruff, right? They may not understand how often do you shampoo it? You know, what are the best products to use? How often do you get this, a retouch, right? Can you do it at home? So if you become the lock expert, people are now following you, because every single day you're giving tips on how to style locks, how to treat your locks. If your locks get damaged, if they get dreaded, if you're wanting to start locks, you know, sister locks, regular locks, you be the lock expert. So people will now follow you because they're either thinking about starting a lock journey, they have one, but they feel like, you know, that they can just be a little neater or cleaner. So now you're the lock expert, and now you can sell this ebook all day, every day, while you at the grocery store, while you sleep, while you doing work, so about lock maintenance. Okay? You can then maybe do an e-course. So let's just say I'm a hairstylist, right? I may know weaves and natural hair, but I got all these people asking me about locks. I don't do them. There's no one in my area that does. And I'm like, well, I want to learn about locks. Well, either give me a one-on-one course, but that's going to be your time, or sell a course. How do you lock hair? What is the procedure? So now you just turn on your computer, record yourself on Zoom, walking through the steps on how do you lock. And I don't know nothing about no locks, okay? So do you part the hair? Like, what do you do? What are the products? Give me links to the products, you know, blah, blah, blah. You can even have a hands-on course. Well, hey, girl, I want to come to Baltimore. I mean, I got the course and all, but I want to come to Baltimore. I want to meet you, and I want you just to help me get this together. Well, now you got you a VIP day one-on-one special you can give people, and you're going to show them hands-on how to do the lock. So now you're still doing hair, but you can now break down that one business into multiple streams of income. So you got that one-on-one coaching, you got the e-course and your ebook. So now you're selling to other hairstylists. You want to either improve your lock game or learn the lock game. And then everyone who has locks, baby, are they matted? You know, do they look raggedy? Let me tell you, you know, what are the problems with having locks? If you don't wash your hair every 2 weeks, this will happen. Girl, I gotta wash my hair? She didn't tell me that. Now people are understanding, oh, well, let me go ahead and get this ebook so I can make sure that my locks are together. So that's not going to be a lot of upfront money. You don't have to go buy products and, you know, say you can go do this, baby, with maybe $200 or less.
Yeah.
You can go on Fiverr.com, have someone type up the ebook, or you can go on Canva and do your own little ebook. But that's a quick way to, but everybody on Instagram, you have to show up. Now your locks got to be together, Miss Tish. You're going to be the lock expert. You got to come on there. I would have some kind of branded t-shirt or however you want to look, but you got to come on there every day giving tips. So you can take one day out the week, a Sunday, get your little self together, get a tripod from Amazon, and on your Sunday, take 1 hour out, give me at least 10 one-minute videos. That's going to be your content for the week. So while you may not wear makeup every day, you know, I don't know what you do, Miss Tish, but That way you don't have to be all dolled up every single day if you don't wear makeup every single day. Or you may have a bad hair day, you're not tripping because you already have your content for the whole week that you cut on Sunday. And then every day you just post that content. Then next Sunday, get yourself together and shoot your content. Content could be, oh my gosh.
I got my best friend to buy me a tripod.
Okay. You can talk about products. This is the so and so.
I got it for Christmas.
Okay.
Joy, we have some homework to do. Are we going to talk about our homework?
The homework is going to be finish the movie Founder, if you haven't already finished Founder.
It was good.
We're also going to talk about the seasons, okay? So write down when you've been in your harvest season, when you've been in your dark season, and when you've been in your planting season. And write that down in your journal for your personal life and then your professional or your business life. So we can start identifying like what the seasons look like that we've already been through. And then once we write down the seasons, an example of the different seasons that we've already been through, what is going to be our game plan as to how we're going to maintain ourselves in that dark season? So I remember when I was in my dark season, it was this and that. So what are some tools that I can start developing right now, or some routines that when I get in my dark season, I already have a game plan how to get through? Is that going to be, I need to be, you know, reading, are you a book reader? Are you a YouTuber? Are you a gospel song? Are you I got to go to church. I got to do my meditation. I got to be on a schedule. I got to exercise. What is it that kind of keeps you zoned in? So I know the next time I'm in my dark season, or I'm in my dark season right now, I already have a toolkit as to where I'm going to pull from to be able to help navigate this storm. It's going to be dark. These winds are slapping us up and down. We're getting these Mike Tyson blows. What do I do to be able to get back up? You are getting knocked down in the dark season. What are my tools to get back up? And that's going to be your toolkit. So when you get back in your dark season, I'm going right to my toolkit. So finishing Founder, writing down an example of when you've been on all three seasons in your personal and your professional life, and then coming up with your own toolkit as to what you're doing. Now, the toolkit is not just for the dark season. So part of these tools, we got to make into a daily routine. If we're not constantly filling ourselves up, we're going to be depleted and drained, right? So we're doing some of these things, but then when it gets real dark, I got some extra heavy duty tools in my kit that I already know I need to go here to help me get through and weather the storm. So now we already have a game plan. So if you're not in your dark season, when you do fall into it, you already know what to do. And if you are in your dark season right now, you're already coming up with ways as to how to just to weather the storm. I need to just keep myself filled up enough just to get through it. So is it affirmations? Is it, you know, writing in a journal our feelings? Is it, you know, every single day I'm going to write, you know, 10 things of what I'm thankful for? Like a gratitude journal? Is there like a certain person I like to listen to on YouTube? Is it a certain book that, you know, everyone is different. You got to find your mix, your jelly, what works for you. And that's going to kind of keep you sustained to be able to get through all the punches in that dark season. But now we have a toolkit because, like I said, it's a season. So once we get out the dark, we're going to be in our harvest, and then we're coming right back around. So next time we get in our dark season, it's not going to be a shocker. We already know what this is.
Got it.
morning. Well, everyone have a great Tuesday night, and I will see you guys on Thursday. Bye.
Thank you, Miss Joy.
You're welcome. Bye.